Lewisham Council reacted tonight by ordering a full inquiry into the events that led up to today's conviction of Ronald Cooper. At a news conference, Social Services Chairman Clive Jordan urged staff, parents and former residents of Lewes to give evidence. He admitted Lewisham Social Services had had no indication of what was going on at the home before Ronald Cooper's arrest.
It seems now, though, even today, when you knew the case was coming up, that you have only, in many ways, a very vague idea about what was actually going on at the home.
I don't know. That's not correct. What we have is the information that was presented in court today by the police.
Don't you have information of your own, though, about what was happening in one of your homes?
And that will be, what information we have will be made available to the inquiry. But obviously, if there had been any evidence at all available to the council, the officers of the council, that something of this kind was going on, then it would have been dealt with at the time.
One of the inquiry's tasks will be to investigate how Ronald Cooper's activities were able to go undiscovered for so long. To do that, it'll be trying to obtain access to the evidence compiled by the police, which so far, said Councillor Jordan, the council hasn't seen.
Although Lewisham Council are adamant there will be an inquiry, they say it'll be in private. They say the findings will eventually be published, but that none of the names of those involved will be revealed, and that includes council officers. This is Steve Clark at Lewisham Town Hall for Thames News.